Well then, look at this pack. There's Gilded Lotus, Vidalcan Shackles, Path to Exile, Upheaval, Frost Titan, and Edric as cards I could potentially want, though Edric's probably last on that list. Same with Path, so I've eliminated those two. So now there are some pretty good competition here. I actually don't think this is an Upheaval deck. I don't really have a way to generate mana, and I don't have that much that can really give me an advantage once I Upheaval. I know that this card is regarded as one of the best cards in Cube, because there are decks in which it's insane, especially decks with Gilded Lotus. But I think in a deck like this, I'd rather just have, like, Vidalcan Shackles. I don't think I need another 6-drop. I think this is, like, a cheap mid-range card, which is really, really powerful. And I do have a Hallowed Fountain and a Steam Vents as non-basics that count as islands. So even though I'm playing Colonnade and Mystic Gate, I don't think that my mana is going to suffer too much. I get to play a bunch of islands along with those. Yeah, this pack's insane. I wouldn't be surprised if I wield at the very least a Repeal, but Vidalcan Shackles is a really nice one. Followed up by Faith's Fetters. I mean, I'm not going to take a second pick Silver Knight or a Steel Moon Cavalier. Yosei is not bad, but I like Faith's Fetters a little more, I guess. It's not the most inspiring. I mean, Serum Visions isn't bad either, but if Preordained wield, Serum Visions is definitely wheeling. I think Faith's Fetters does the trick here. Firmly landing on the control side, it looks like, and followed up with a Serendip Ifrit, or just an Electrolyze. I've got the two red lands to splash with. I think Electrolyze might actually be the pick. The card is nice, and this card wheels fairly often, so I'm just going to go with Electrolyze for a moment. Alright, this is nonsense. I guess I'm going to take Hokori Dustdrinker, because I'm not splashing Devil's Play, Skill the Vampire, Cough the Hammer. Yeah, I'm not playing any of these cards. Hokori, I suppose I could play. Maybe go, lean back towards the aggro side a little bit. At the very least, it's a powerful card, even though I don't really want to pick that up there. Jeez, Domri Raid. While Reverence is a good sideboard card, but I think I'm more inclined to take Looter or Mana Tithe, and I think it's actually just going to be Looter. I like having a little 2-drop that can cycle through my deck. I've got some powerful cards going on, so Looter it is. And Momentary Blink, what do I got going on with that? I've got Wall of Omens it's good with, Geist it's good with, Sower it's decent with. I guess Shapeshifter, so it's Blink or Daze. I do like Daze though, Daze is a pretty strong card. There's also Marsh Flats, which is not bad either, because it basically just gets Hallowed Fountain. Unfortunately cannot get Steam Vents, though it can get Sacred Foundry. So Marsh Flats is actually a pretty good pick here too. I think I'm actually just going to take the Marsh Flats, hope to wield a Blink. There can't be that many other decks that want it. And even if I don't wield it, I mean, picking up good fixing is pretty important. Alright, I'll follow up with Thalia actually seems good. I've got a lot of creatures in my deck. Even though I have Shackles, Absorb, Electrolyze, Forbid, Elspeth, Faith's Fetters, the rest of my deck is creatures, and that includes all the expensive spells. I like Into the Royal and all that, but Thalia I think is pretty strong. Ooh, so is Counterspell, even stronger than Glacial Fortress. Alright, so I've got 23 playables now, so that's good. I guess Chromox is the 23rd, but yeah, I like the way this goes. I mean, this deck's not doing anything broken, but it's got a pretty good selection of powerful cards. And I think it's got enough internal synergy that I don't think it's going to go too badly. Alright, well, looks like no one else wants Upheaval either. Do I take it now, or do I just take the Frost Titan? There's a Repeal also, but I think between Burst Lightning and Electrolyze, plus Shackles, Faith's Fetters, and then a couple Counterspells, I think I don't need too much more in the way of Repeal. And I think I'm just going to take Frost Titan. Again, to forestall all the comments, Upheaval is good, but how much mana does this deck need before Upheaval becomes insane? You even have Thalia in it, too. I think Frost Titan is quite defensible. I'm going to take Silver Knight now, since I think it's more likely that I play that than Steel Moon Cavalier, and the decks that Silver Knight is good against, it is insane against. And I'll just take a Vindicate, though I'm not playing it. Take someone's Simic Growth Chamber, side in a Manrique Usari. I could play Simic Growth Chamber and Yavimaya Coast to play Shardless Agent, but I think I'll pass on that. Alright, let's hide the Growth Chamber. Hide the Manrique Usari. Not hiding the Silver Knight quite yet. Hiding the Vindicate, though. Alright, so this is... And Momentary Blink. Ooh! Do I want the Momentary Blink? Probably do. I mean, it seems like it's got a number of decent combos. Well, I guess if I'm actually playing Honor of the Pure, then probably don't, because if I play Honor, I've got to play like Silver Knight and Kami Vengeance Law. I'm going to play Thalia no matter what. But if I don't play the Honor of the Pure, I can probably end up getting in some decent stuff instead. Alright, let's just put in Well, I guess Hikori is not a lock. I think Decree's a lock. Decree's pretty good. Put in all the counter spells. I think the Looter's gonna be fine. And I think I want Electrolyze as well. Alright. So this is 19. Go by mana cost. Eh, things look alright. Got a couple counters. Three counter spells is not actually a terrible amount. Thalia is a little bit of disruption. I've got some decent threats here. This deck is a little mid-range. Oh, there's also Burst Lightning, which I think I like, because I do have three red sources for free, basically, which is good. There's also Maze of Ith has potential, so I want like three more cards, and I'm going to play 16 land and probably play Chromalux. Actually, I don't know. Power God Elspeth's insane, Power God Geist is insane. The rest is actually not that insane, and this deck has no card draw, so that makes Mox a lot worse. I mean, my only card draw is Restoration Angeling a Wall of Omens. Yeah, and I have a Looter. Yeah, I'm going to pass on the Mox, I think. It's good with Hikori, which I'm not sure if I'm playing either. So, one package could be Honor of the Pure, Silver Knight, Kami of Ancient Law. That leaves me with a bunch more 2-drops, and Honor of the Pure, which is good with, like, I have, what, 3 different Token Makers? Well, I guess this also kind of counts. And, what, 3, 4, 5, essentially, 6, 7, 8, 9 white creatures that can attack, 10 white creatures that can attack, if you count that. That's not too bad. The other question is, what I want Momentary Blink, which, again, combos with Geist, combos with Shapeshifter, combos with Wall of Omens to some degree, combos with Sower, definitely. I guess combos with Frost Titan. Yeah, I think I'd actually rather just I'm going to try the Honor of the Pure. It seems a little loose, but I think it'll be decent. Gives a lot of my creatures plus and plus one, or possibly more. Alright, let's try this. Ooh, piles by color, so I think the 3 red sources is actually just going to be enough. I don't think I need to add any more. And then, definitely playing Colonnade. Another card for Honor of the Pure. I'm not going to play the Maze of Ith, though it's a good sideboard card, I think. So I need 11 more lands. Good. Magic Online suggests 5/5/1. Probably going to go down on that, and then probably another island, just so I have 6, 7, 8, 9 actual islands, which is, I guess, on the low end, but I really, you know, if I was going by mana costs, I would actually just go 6 planes, 5 islands, probably, just because I have so many white cards. But this still gives me 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 white sources, which I wouldn't want to go below, but I think is enough. Alrighty. Yeah, this deck looks decent. It's a little too mid-range for my taste, just because you end up not really being super aggressive, not being super control-ish, but that being said, I think the card power is pretty good, and I've got some good curves and some good potential openings.